And now Storm Tracker weather with meteorologist Paul Beam.
All right, we are going to start with that storm tracker because a lot of those flooding advisories and warnings that we were seeing yesterday are finally starting to make their way out. The only one that's remaining is the one in the Port Neuf River, and that is slightly above flood stage. Flood stage is 9 feet. It's around 9.5 right now. So as we move forward, that's going to slowly start to make its way down too, because the precipitation has been weakening as we quickly move forward into a partly cloudy night and then into a scattered clouds of the morning in the Snake River Plain, although the Tetons still have a little bit more to go because a lot of this snow is heading in their direction. As we zoom out, the strongest of that snow is still over Wyoming, a little bit into the Dakotas and Nebraska, but for the most part, that's still moving to the east. A lot of us are in the clear and we're only seeing a little bit of scattered flakes all day long, and then finally once we hit tomorrow, it's going to fully push out for a couple days, and then we have another system making its way in right around Wednesday, so expect to see more snow from that and a lot of snow rain mix in the Snake River Plain. So mountains more so seeing the snow from this next one, but future tracker still seeing a little bit of that very scattered snow near Blackfoot, Pocatello, Idaho Falls, all the way down that I-15 corridor into early tomorrow. But as we move that forward, it quickly makes its way out. So during the daytime hours, it is gone. But over in the Tetons, still seeing a lot of that scattered snow. And once we hit the late half of that day, around 5, 6 o'clock, almost all of it moves into Wyoming, and we start to see more of those clear skies, a little bit of a warm-up associated with that as well. So we are going to continue to see a little bit closer to those spring temperatures that we're hoping to see fully by the end of next week. Tonight, Snake River Plain scattered mix, 28 in Pocatello, 24 in Idaho Falls. So expect to see, if we do see a little bit of that scattered rain coming through, it is also going to bring some ice and some snow because it is slightly below freezing. As we head over the Central Mountains, cold with clouds and cold as in teens, with single digits in Stanley at 7, and then scattered snow in the highlands of West Wyoming as they're seeing that snow head in their direction, 16 in Island Park, 21 in Jackson. But it's continuing to see that tomorrow as well. 34 in Island Park, 35 in Jackson with that scattered snow moving through. The Central Mountains very similar with that mostly cloudy conditions, but staying a little bit warmer than what we have seen the last couple days, 45 in Challis, 48 in Salmon. Then finally for the Snake River Plain, scattered clouds, 45 in Pocatello, 44 in Idaho Falls. We are very slowly warming up. That's a 1 degree warmth, one more degree up from what we saw today. It was 44 today in Pocatello, 45 for tomorrow. So expect to see those temperatures slightly rise, but still seeing a little bit of moisture here and there. Nothing nearly as strong as what we saw early on Saturday. And of course, you can see Wednesday and Friday with a couple scattered storms, but not enough to halt that warm-up that we're seeing in Pocatello. Those mid-50s by Wednesday, Thursday, and then 60 on Friday with a slight cool-down for next weekend. But you really can't complain about those upper 50s from after some of the cool-downs that we've seen in the last few weeks. Idaho Falls seeing a little bit more snow from Thursday until Sunday. It kind of just stays as a pesky annoyance because it's not very strong, but it is consistently through Thursday and Sunday. And then as we move over to the Tetons, this is where we usually see a lot of that snow. Monday, Wednesday, and then Wednesday all the way until Sunday, seeing a little bit of scattered here and there, but Wednesday definitely being the strongest, with the Central Mountains following a very similar pattern. Although they don't see it tomorrow, they do have it on Wednesday and Friday, and we're seeing those temperatures once again in those mid-50s, so it is
not too shabby.
Slowly warming up. We're slowly starting to see that spring.
All right, Paul, thank you very much.